गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, आई एम प्रोफेसर सोनाली सुर्वे फ्रॉम डी वाई पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग कोल्हापुर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सेक्शन 3 यूनिट 3 ऑफ कंप्यूटर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड आर्किटेक्चर विच इज अर्थमेटिक ऑपरेशन. इन अर्थमेटिक ऑपरेशन वी हैड ऑलरेडी सीन हाउ टू परफॉर्म एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन इन कंप्यूटर्स. Now today we are going to see how to perform multiplication in computers. To perform the multiplication, we need two operands. The first one is called multiplicand and the second one is called multiplier. Whenever we are going to perform the multiplication, we are assuming two things. The first thing is that both the operand should have same number of bits. For example, if I am multiplying 2 with 11, so 2 is represented by 0, 1, 0, whereas 11 is represented by 1, 0, 1, 1. So to represent 3, 2 bits or 3 bits are required, whereas to represent 11, you require 4 bit. But whenever you are going to perform a multiplication, both the bit should be having same numbers, that is both the number should have same number of bits. So how we are going to represent 2? We are going to represent it by a 4 bit representation, which is 0, 0, 1, 0. How we are going to represent 11? 1, 0, 1, 1. Now also we have to assume that the first bit is the sign bit. So in this case, now our 2 will be represented by 5 bits, which is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 11 will be represented by 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So most significant bit in both the cases is positive, which represent the sign of the two numbers. Then second assumption we have to make is that whatever multiplication we are going to store, the answer will be stored in double the number of bits of operand. That is, if our 2 and 11 are represented by 5 bit, then the multiplication will be represented by 10 bits. 5 plus 5 is 10. An important thing to consider, the most significant bit is always representing the sign. So if the most significant bit is 0, it means it is a positive number. If most significant bit is 1, it means that it is a negative number. Now whatever method we are going to see, the first method is sign extension method, and it is a by hand method of multiplication. Now whenever you are multiplying two numbers, there are four cases. The first case, both the number are positive. Example, 2 multiplied by 11. Second case, first number is negative and second number is positive. That is minus 2 multiplied by 11. Third case, first is positive, second is negative. For example, 2 multiplied by minus 11. And fourth case, negative negative, that is minus 2 multiplied by minus 11. So what the first method that we are going to see, a by hand method, is called a sign extension method. Now this sign extension method will work very well for the first case, that is positive positive. It will also work for negative positive. It will also work for negative negative, but there is a problem when it is working for positive negative. That is, when the first number is positive and second number is negative, then in this case, this sign extension method will not work. So what is the solution? The solution is that you have to take inverse of both the numbers. For example, in this case, 2 multiplied by minus 11. So the second number is negative and we can't do the multiplication by sign extension method. So what we are doing is that we are taking the inverse. So what is the inverse of the first number plus 2? It will be minus 2. And what is the inverse of the second number minus 11? It will be plus 11. So 2 multiplied by minus 11 is converted into minus 2 multiplied by 11, and then sign extension method is used for multiplication. So you can say that this is the limitation of sign extension multiplication method, which is a by hand method. So we'll take one example. Let us multiply 2 with a 3. Now 2, we are representing it as 0, 0, 1, 0. In this case, remember that the MSB is always the sign bit. So it is positive, hence it is 0. 3 is represented as 0, 0, 1, 1. Again, positive, so MSB 0. Now multiply these two things. 0, 0, 1, 0 multiplied by 0, 0, 1, 1. So now we take the first least significant bit of the second number, 1. When 1 is multiplied with 0, 0, 1, 0, we are getting the answer as 0, 0, 1, 0. 1 multiplied by anything will get the anything answer. Next, shift it to left by 1 bit position. So the next we are going to get is next 1. Again multiply this 1 with 0, 0, 1, 0. So the answer we are getting is 0, 0, 1, 0. Next is 0. 0 multiplied with anything is always equal to 0. So we are getting a 0s, 4 0s over here. And again shift to the left and again we are getting a 4 0s. Now you can see that there is something written in the red. This is a sign extension. So in this method what we are doing is that we are extending the MSB. Now in the first case, what is the MSB? MSB is 0. So we are extending. That means we are putting 4 0s before this MSB. Why 4 0s? We want our answer to be an 8 bit answer because our operands are 4 bit. So already I have 4 bit of an answer with me and I require 4 bit, therefore I am extending my MSB 4 times. In the second case, I am extending it to 3 times because already 4 is there and this one has been shifted. So I am going to get an 8 bit answer anyway. In the third line, it has been extended 2 times and in the fourth line, it is extended only 1 time. Now add all this up. So 0 gives you 0, 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 1 plus 0 is 1, remaining all are 0s, so everything will be 0. So what answer I get? I get the answer as 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Now this is an 8 bit answer. In the 8 bit answer, the 7 bits are the magnitude bit and the MSB is the sign bit. So the magnitude tells me that the answer is 6, whereas the sign bit tells me that the answer is positive. Getting it? Now let us go to the second example, minus 2 multiplied by 3. Now minus 2. In computer, always the minus is represented in two ways. First, by using 1's complement. Second, by using 2's complement. 2's complement are most appropriate to perform any arithmetic operation. Therefore, what we are going to do? We are going to take 2's complement of a negative number. So here the negative number is minus 2. Now we want to take 2's complement. So how to take 2's complement? To take 2's complement first convert it to its binary. So the binary representation of 2 is 0, 0, 1, 0. Next, take its 1's complement. So what is 1's complement of 0, 0, 1, 0? It is 1, 1, 0, 1. How did I obtain it? You just have to flip it. That is 1 will be 0, 0 will be 1. Then to this 1's complement we are adding 1. So 1, 1, 0, 1 plus 1 will give me 1, 1, 1, 0. So this is 2's complement of minus 2. So now take this 2's complement. So my minus 2 is now represented as 1, 1, 1, 0. And my 3 is represented as 0, 0, 1, 1. Perform multiplication as we did earlier. So the least significant bit of the second number is multiplied entirely with the first number. So 1 multiplied with 1, 1, 1, 0 will give me 1, 1, 1, 0. Over here you can see. Next is what? Again shift left by 1 bit position. Take the next number, it is 1. Again multiplied with 1, 1, 1, 0. So it is again 1, 1, 1, 0. Next 0, 0 multiplied by anything is 0. And next also 0. Next what we have to do? We have to extend the sign bit. Now what is the sign bit over here? It is 1. So extend the sign bit. So this 1 is extended 4 times. 1, 1, 1, 1. Come to the next line. 1 extended 3 times. Come to the next line. MSB is 0 extended 2 times. Come to the next line. MSB is 0 extended to the 1 time. Now perform addition. So 0, 1 plus 0 gives me 1. 1 plus 1 plus 0 gives me 0, carry 1. Next 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1 plus 1 will give me 1. Similarly 1 plus 1 plus 1 will be 1 over here. Go on taking the answers and finally you will see that your answer is exceeding 8 bit. It is coming to the 9th bit. Now we don't have to worry about it. We are just going to discard the bit. So what will be my answer? My answer will be 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. Next, what you have to do? Just check that the most significant bit of the answer is 1. 1 indicates that it is a negative number. So to obtain the magnitude of the negative number, again you have to do the 2's complement of the particular number. So what I am going to do? I am going to take 2's complement of the number 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. So by using the same method as we did earlier, I took 2's complement and I got it as 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. The magnitude is what? 6. But the sign is negative because our MSB was 1. Getting it? Now come to the third case. 2 multiplied by minus 3. As I have said that the sign extension by hand will not work for this. So what you have to do? You have to take inverse of both the numbers. So the inverse of plus 2 will be minus 2 and inverse of minus 3 will be plus 3. So 2 multiplied by minus 3 is taken as minus 2 multiplied by 3. So obtain the inverse and perform the multiplication in the same way as we did earlier. And then last one is minus 2 multiplied by minus 3. So minus 2 multiplied by minus 3, how we are going to do the multiplication? Take 2's complement of 2, takes 3, 2's complement of 3, then perform the multiplication. So you just try for it and see what sign bit and what magnitude bit you are getting. So this is the sign extended multiplication method, and this is a by hand method. This is not the best method because it has a limitation that we cannot perform multiplication with plus and minus, plus 2 into minus 3. You have to treat it in a different way. You have to take the inverse and then perform the multiplication. That is, the method is not uniform everywhere. Therefore, we are going for the next method, which is called as a Boots multiplication algorithm.